about halfway between Tettingen and the Lateswald. The Lateswald is directly in front of me, and Tettingen is behind me. But the Germans attacked. They came from the high ground of the Lateswald through this gully, and then had to move up again to Tettingen. Now, as you can see, Tettingen is a little higher up. The Germans had the advantage when they moved up. They also disappeared in the gully, so US troops couldn't engage them immediately. But once they started coming up the slopes towards Tettingen, of course, that was a perfect killing ground, resulting in many casualties on the German side. And the attack failed, and it was a very costly one in terms of lives lost. And when I make a small sweep, then just to the right of the tree, you see this group of white houses, and this is the halfway house. So this is what they used as their jump off position, basically, for the attack on Butzdorf, which is just a little further up the road. Now I'm standing just west of Tettingen, next to the main road that leads to somewhere in between Beech and Nennich on the Moselle. And if you would have taken the side road back in 1945, as you can still do now, you would drive straight into Nennich. On the night of the 17th, Tettingen was held by C Company 376th Infantry, while Butzdorf, further up ahead, was still held by A Company 376th. This patch of forest, the northern edge of the Monkey Ranch woods, extending all the way towards the Moselle, and then you have, of course, some flats and some grassy terrain, so it's not all the way until the Moselle, but it's a fair end, about halfway from where I'm standing now. That was covered by B Company. So at that time, the Monkey Ranch woods were not entirely cleared of German troops. And then when A Company was pulled out of Butzdorf, Butzdorf was abandoned. Tettingen, of course, the Americans held on to that. But the 1st Battalion 376th was taken off the line, except for B Company. And they remained in these woods for three miserable day and nights, as Eugene McCaw, he remembers. Directly west of Tettingen, 3rd Platoon of B Company 376th Infantry was dug in. Then in the center of the line was 1st Platoon, which also held the command post for B Company. And then at the far edge, at the end of the forest, into the field where a German communication trench ran, was 2nd Platoon with Eugene McCoy in it. To my back is the road again, and this is about where the Monkey Ranch woods end. They continue back there, and this is where 1st Platoon had its border with 2nd Platoon, and both were of B Company 376th. McCaw, he remembers that he was basically on a hill overlooking a gully, and he was in what he called a German communication trench. So I'm going to make my way through this field, then I'm going to show you just what I am looking at, and I'm going to explain a little about what the situation was back in 1945. I'm standing at the edge of the woods. You can see some orchards. The road toward Nennich is somewhere there in the valley. It's going straight up. And this would be the gully that Eugene McCoy in 2nd Platoon B Company 376th Infantry was looking across. And what you see there is the Lateswald running all the way from basically Putzdorf, that is in this direction over there. You can see Tettingen where the windmills are. So the Lateswald goes all the way across the ridge and it goes all the way
to Nennig.
So basically German troops were able to move freely from Nennig to the positions north of Butzdorf, basically unseen. And trenches are running from Nennig in the Lateswald all the way to the positions just north of Butzdorf. There were trenches in the fields as well, but most of them were in the woods with shelter positions, elaborate shelter positions and fighting positions. So the Germans basically had this part of the line fairly well covered. The communication trench Eugene McCoy describes while being in the second platoon positions to the extreme west of Tettingen runs right where I'm standing here. Perhaps you can discern the zigzagging shape. It follows the edge of the woods and then continues across from the road into the Monkey Wrench woods again. I'm going to follow it a bit here and show you where we get when I follow this one, because Eugene McCoy describes that he followed the trench back to a couple of bunkers where he had some hot coffee, and that is where I'm going now. Now I'm basically following this trench through the woods. It's to my left. I'm arriving at a little deeper section near the edge of the woods, which I'm going to show you. Of course, they had communication trenches. The Germans had communication trenches running through the woods, and then at strategic points on the edges, they would have had what they called Schützenlöcher. They were deeper and they could step up a little step and fire out from them. Or they had MG positions or observation posts built in, and then it continued to another outpost or dugout or stuff like that. And then when I move along the edge of the woods, I come to the place where the bunkers are. Now, there's not much to see, but you see the hole over there, and that's basically the vertical wall of the bunker. It has completely been covered, so the entrance is completely gone, but it should be there somewhere. So I'm going to film inside to give you an impression. Someone has been doing some digging here and cleared it. This is where second platoon men went back to have some shelter and some coffee, some shelter from the cold, of course, and some coffee, even if cold, but it was coffee. And besides, from the German communication trench that ends with the position that I showed you earlier, there are some foxholes still in these woods. Basically, this was first platoon's position, as second platoon was in the field beyond, but probably second platoon men were allowed to get to the bunkers real quick and as I said, have a cup of coffee, have a rest, warm up. Okay, I'm making my way back to the road now, and then I'll move along. And the trench that goes over there to the observation post and the bunkers, it continues across from the street over here, and it continues all the way into the Monkey Wrench woods, basically following the edge of the woods. And then in some instances you see forks with where another trench attaches, and these forks lead to the edge of the woods to fighting positions or observation posts. And then amidst the orchards that are high up here. These were all the positions for the 2nd Platoon B Company 376th. And then to my back again is Monkey Ranch Woods. And in the back over there, you can see across the Moselle. And a little further up ahead is where I Company 376th had their positions. So I Company's 3rd Battalion of the 376th Infantry Regiment. So they were just up ahead. I hope I was able to inform you on some of the events that took place here around Tettingen, around Butzdorf, early 1945. We've seen parts of Sins, we've seen parts of Wochen, we've seen parts of Tettingen in depth, and this was very much about the 376th Infantry Regiment, the unit in which Lauren B. Marx served. If you want to know more about B Company, Lauren B. Marx, 1st Battalion 376th, and their history fighting their way through Europe from France until into Czechoslovakia, I suggest you read Letters from Lauren. It's available through Amazon, and it's about the journey of Lauren B. Marx, who was in 2nd Platoon B Company 376th Infantry. So, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. Look up my Facebook page. So, and then, well, until the next video.